Hello everyone, am I audible to you?
Yes, sir.
Yes. We have started, I think, genetics. Okay. Yes, everyone. Let's start with genetics. Have we done this thing? This thing is done now? Everyone? Yes. Let's see. Mendel has discussed these 7 pair of contrasting character that were there. Yes or no? No issues. They were contrasting. Okay, one is dominant and one is recessive. We are going to discuss what is dominant and what is recessive later on. Okay. Yes. There are few. You all can see the comparison was the character is seed shape. Dominant word, round trait, recessive trait. If you will talk about seed color, which is yellow and green, yellow is the dominant one. Green is a recessive trait. Getting my point? If you will talk about pod color actually, green is dominant, yellow is recessive. It suppose it, you all can see over here, flower color, violet, white is recessive, flower position is there. So axial flower and terminal flower over here. Terminal is one which is at the end. So it is flower position. Stem is tall and dwarf. Tall is dominant and dwarf is recessive. These are the correct characters that were considered by Mendel. Yes or no? We have done this thing. Now, some definitions are there. One definition is of unit factor. Actually, do you people know the term gene was not given by that time? Gene was not given at that time. Mendel has used the term unit factor. Agreed? Everyone? I'm audible to you all, na?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Mendel has given the term unit factor. And he's told some unit factor is there. Okay, which is the unit of inheritance and which controls a trait singly in case of haploid and along with another factor of similar type in case of diploid organism. You people understand haploid and diploid now?
Yes, sir.
Haploid having only one set of chromosome and diploid having two sets of chromosome. Yes or no? Agreed, everyone? Haploid having only one set of chromosome and diploid having two sets of chromosome. They are known as homologous pair. Yes or no? Tell me, dear.
No.
Now, gene. The unit factor of Mendel was called gene by Johansson. Johansson was the scientist in 1909. Only the name has changed. Function remained the same. Gene is the unit of inheritance which is carried from parent to gamete. Gene is unit of inheritance which is carried from parent to parent by gamete.
So we can't hear you.
Now?
Yes, sir.
Yes. You people should reply a bit, okay? You should reply because let's see what I want to tell you all. This is the structure of a chromosome. What?
Chromosome.
These two are what? Sister chromatid. Okay. Yes or no? So if capital T is the allele present over here, what do you think? Which allele should be there at this place? Capital T or a small t? Or it can be either. It should be capital T or a small t at this point. This point. If here it is capital T, what should be there at this place? Now, Pranav, am I audible now? Pranav, am I audible now? Yes. Let's see what I want to tell you over here. What I want to tell you over here. One more chart is there. Yes. I am saying in this chromosome, if here capital T is there, what should be there at this place? Should it be capital T or a small t? Please reply. Yes. See, if you will try to understand how this second allele is formed, you will get to know. Am I audible to everybody now? You can reply. You can reply. You can speak up. Let's see. See, actually what happens, this is your capital T. During S phase, what will happen? Only this is going to be replicated. Doubling will be there in S phase. What will happen? If this T will be copied as it is, it should be T only. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So it will be capital T only. Agreed? Let's see. These two are homologous chromosome. These two are homologous chromosome actually, if I will let you know. And let's see, here it is going to be capital T only. If here it is capital T, here again it will be capital T. Agreed? Here it is capital T, here it will be capital T. If here it is a small t, it will be a small t. Here a small t and here a small t. Agreed? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Agreed, everyone? Let's see. This condition is going to be known as T. This condition is going to be known as T. And this condition is known as a small t. Agreed? This will be known as, I'm going to tell you how gametes are going to be formed. Getting my point? Let's see. This is a small t. This is capital T, a small t. This is known as homozygous dominant condition. This is known as heterozygous condition. This is known as homozygous recessive condition. Yes or no? everyone.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
See, why it is homozygous? Because both are same. Why it is heterozygous? Because they are different. And why it is homozygous? Because they are same. The reason of being dominant or recessive, it is going to be different. Okay. Now see, how gamete is going to be formed? If this is your chromosome, na? For that you need to have, you can say, you need to have knowledge of meiosis actually. It will divide from here, centromere, and this will split into two parts. Agreed? Division will be there from the center like this. And you are going to receive this thing and this thing as gamete. So here, two will be there from this and two will be there from this. Total four gametes will be formed. Yes or no? From one homologous pair of chromosome. Agreed here?
So can you repeat that?
I'm going to make that only. Let's see. From one chromosome, how many gametes are getting formed? Two. Yes or no? So from one pair, homologous chromosome, how many gametes will be formed?
Four.
And each will be containing capital T in this case. Here, only one type of gamete will be formed. That will be containing
capital T.
Capital T. Agreed, everyone? Which will be containing capital T. Agreed? Say yes or no.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Everyone. Now, using the similar funda, how many types of gamete are going to be formed over here?
Two types.
One is, I am saying how many types, not the number. From one cell, there are four gametes are going to be formed always. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
One will be there, which is a small t. And one will be capital T over here. Yes or no? One will be a small t and one will be capital T over here. Agreed, everyone?
Yes.
Say yes or no?
Yes, sir.
And from here, how many types of gametes are going to be formed?
One.
Only one, that is?
Small t.
If you have some background knowledge of meiosis, okay, in that case, these are homologous pair, na? In first meiosis, they will separate, okay, into two cells. And in the second meiosis, they will divide from here. Yes or no? Yes or no, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Agreed with my points? Let's see. These are the gametes that is being formed. And let's see. Two or more alternate form of a gene are called allele or allelomorphs. And they are present. They are present on the same locus of locus on non-sister chromatid of same locus or non-sister chromatid of what? homologous pair of chromosome. Do you people know what are sister and non-sisters? See, these two chromatids are known as sister chromatids. What? Metids. And these two are known as what? Chromatids. Agreed? This is one pair, homologous pair. Getting my point? This one and this one is non-sister, and two chromatids of the same chromosome is known as sister chromatid. Now try to understand my point. Can sister chromatid having two different forms? I'm saying, can sister chromatids or sister chromatids can have two different forms or not?
No, sir.
No, sister chromatid will not have. And only difference will be there if here it is capital T, on other sister chromatid, it must be capital T only. Only on the non-sister chromatid, you can change that. Yes or no? Agreed? Everyone? Do you people agree with definition of mine?
Yes, sir.
Everyone?
So what is locus?
Yes, sir.
Locus is a position, you know? In DNA, that particular place is known as locus. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
Everyone, now, Mendel's law of inheritance. Mendel's law of inheritance. For that, you have to read some of the Mendel's cross, because two, three kind of crosses are there. Okay. Some are based on monohybrid cross. Some are based on, you can say, dihybrid cross. First thing that you people must be knowing, what is monohybrid cross? Monohybrid cross. Mono means one. Agreed, everyone? Mono means one. Agreed, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Mono means one. And it means only you are, how many characters Mendel has, you can say, pair of character Mendel has, you can say, taken for his experiments? Seven pairs. Out of that, you are considering only one pair. Means inheritance of only one gene is considered over here. Like here, I am making the, see, what is this structure known as? This is known as Punnett square. What? Punnett square. It is developed by a British geneticist, Reginald C. Punnett. And it is the graphical representation to calculate the probability of all possible genotype of offspring in genetic cross. Now, here you have seen a word genotype and another is phenotype. What? Genotype. What is genotype? It is the genetic composition. What? Like this plant is, this is TT. This is genotype. And now if I will see that plant, what it will look like? Pranav, what do you want to, you want to copy this? Yes, you people can copy. Few of you have asked, I think Ritu has asked one question on Turner syndrome, and one more student has asked me two questions today. You people are there in the class?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
We will be discussing those questions at the end.
Yes, sir.
Please remember. Done? Are we done? Now see, genotype is the genetic composition. That capital T or capital T, small t, or a small t is what? Genotype. Yes or no? Now, one is phenotype. What is phenotype? Phenotype is the external appearance, is the external morphological appearance, like being tall, being short, being green, being wrinkled, being round, all these things are what? Phenotype. Yes or no? Agreed here? Everyone, are you getting it?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So what he has done, he has taken a tall plant and a dwarf plant. He has made a cross between them. Now see, capital T is there, means condition is this one. Here also capital T is there, and here. So how many types of gamete will be produced over here? Capital T and capital T. Yes or no? Everyone? Capital T and capital T. And here? It is pure dwarf. Now you see. One gamete is capital T and one is small t. If that will unite, what will be formed? Capital T and small t. Yes or no? Here. See, one gamete will come from this arm and one will come from this arm. You see, capital T will unite with small t. In that case, again, what will be formed? Capital T, small t. Agreed? No issues? Here also capital T, small t, and here also capital T, small t. Means all will be capital T, small t. Yes or no? Everyone, see over here. This is known as F1 generation. The first filial generation. Yes or no? The first filial generation that is there. Agreed, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Now, important thing. He has subjected plants obtained in the first filial generation for selfing. Means capital T, small t is going to be crossed with capital T, small t. Yes or no? Agreed? Selfing, same plant is used. How many types of gamete will be produced over here? Is it two types? One is capital T and one is small t. You all can see over here. Is it like that? Capital T and a small t. Agreed, dear? Everyone? Yes. And here also capital T, small t. Now try to understand. On this arm, capital T is there, and on this arm also capital T is there. What you are going to obtain? Capital T here, capital T, small t. Sorry, capital T, small t, and capital T, small t. And here it is capital small t. Yes or no? What he has observed? What he has observed? Let's see. He has observed that in the first filial generation, all the plants are tall. His first observation. And in the, he was thinking in first generation that, he was thinking after seeing the F1 generation that dwarf plant has vanished. Yes or no? Dwarf plant has vanished because none of the plant was dwarfed. Yes or dwarf? Yes or no? But surprisingly, he has seen that in second generation, one dwarf plant is recovered. Yes or no? Everyone. One plant was tall, one was dwarf. None of the plant was dwarf in first filial generation. He got amazed that none of the plant is dwarf. Earlier, anybody can think that dwarf plant has vanished. Something had happened because of that. But he has recovered a dwarf plant in the second generation. Yes or no? For that, two things are used. One is phenotypic ratio. Phenotypic ratio. Okay, it is tall is to dwarf. It will be 3:1. Agreed, dear? And this is for F2 generation. What? It is for F2 generation. Agreed? It is for F2 generation, everyone.
Yes.
And what is genotypic ratio? Is capital T is 2, capital T, small t is 2, small t will be 1:2:2. Agreed, everyone? Tell me, dear.
Yes, sir.
Is it all right? Yes. In this way, he has calculated things. Okay, this is the F, you can say monohybrid cross. Based on that, he has given two laws. First law is, inheritance. First is law of dominance. Second is law of segregation. Yes or no? Everyone? There are two laws that is given. Law of dominance and law of segregation. Yes or no? What do you people understand? You can say as per law of dominance. What do you understand? Let's see. I am going to write about law of dominance. Let's see. Let's see, dear. What what is law of dominance first, or you can say any character is controlled by discrete unit, okay, known as factors. Okay, any character is controlled by discrete unit known as factor. From this only he has given, from the monohybrid cross only he has given this law. Yes or no? Yes, you all are right. This is one thing that is known as factor. Okay, then any character is controlled by a pair of factor. Okay, no issues. And in a dissimilar pair, one factor express itself. That will be known as which factor, dominant or recessive?
Dominant.
That will be dominant factor. Factor. And another is masked. And another factor which do not express itself, that will be known as everyone. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Am I right? Everyone, do you have any doubt in this? Yes. Do you think there is any exception to this? See this condition, incomplete dominance. Let's see what you people can make out from this. See what happened in incomplete dominance. One flower is red, another flower is white. You see it is capital R. So how many kind of gametes will be formed from this? Only one, the capital R and a small r from this. So what happened over here? Let's see. The flower obtained in first generation is what? According to law of dominance, it should be which color?
Red.
But it is not red. It is blend of red and white. It becomes pink. Yes or no? Means red has tried to dominate, but not completely. It became what? Incomplete dominance. And this is observed in a plant known as snapdragon. Which plant? Agreed? Here, yes. The color red color red is color red. Yes, I'm going to tell you. Aditya, I'm going to tell you. No issues. See, there are many hypotheses that is given regarding this. I'm going to tell you that. Here, red color is not completely dominant over white color. Rather, it is incompletely dominant over white color. Yes or no, everyone? Tell me. Tell me.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Now you see. Now you see. See the genotypic ratio and phenotypic ratio both. Are they same?
Yes, sir.
Can I say in case of incomplete dominance, in case of incomplete dominance, क्या होता है? Tell me, dear. In case of incomplete dominance, what happens? Genotypic and phenotypic ratio is same. Is it right or wrong? Is it right or wrong? Everyone. Is it right or wrong?
Right, sir.
Right. Everyone. Others also.
Yes, yes. Sir, right.
Let's see now what happens. What happens over here? I will like to tell you all. In this case, what happens? See how it is explained. This is gene, na? This is gene, na? Tell me. So it must be responsible for synthesizing something. It is synthesizing something. Okay. And why it is recessive? It is synthesizing less. Yes or no? That is why it is recessive, na? It is similar. This is the hypothesis that is given. Okay, now see. In this case, the red color is produced in adequate amount. But in this, red color is produced in lesser amount. And in this, red color is not produced. Okay, okay. So this becomes white, okay? This becomes pink and this becomes complete red. Yes or no? If two dominant alleles are there, it do not work in all the cases, but it works in, you can say, some of the cases. If two dominant alleles are produced together, yes or no? If two dominant alleles are produced together, in that case, what happens? There is more synthesis. If only one dominant allele is there, the lesser synthesis. And if two, you can say, alleles are recessive, in that case, even lesser synthesis. Yes or no synthesis. Agreed, dear? Pranab, you got this thing? No, let's see, Pranab, what I tell you. First thing is there, expression of all the expression of gene depends on many factor. Many factor. The same gene is expressing itself in a different way in many organisms. Oh, I think Aditya told me. Aditya told me, sir, then why it is not true for others? Aditya, you got it? Expression of gene is not same in all the animals and organisms, rather. It do not depend only on the alleles, rather on other factors also. Agreed? So they will combine to express themselves like this. Okay? Agreed. Now let's see. One is codominance. Do you people know what is blood group? We have discussed now.
Yes, sir.
We have discussed blood group having three alleles. Three alleles. And what are they? They are actually blood groups are example of multiple allelism. Multiple. One is I, A, one is I, B, and one is I, O. There are three. Agreed? For blood group A, for blood group A, it should be IA, IA, or IA, IO. These two conditions are going to refer to blood group A. Agreed, everyone? Yes. What is blood group B? IB, IB, or IB, IU. Agreed? Then blood group O, IO, IO, and blood group ए बी के लिए क्या होगा? फॉर दिस इट विल बी आई ए एंड आई बी. एग्रीड? कैन यू सी इन ब्लड ग्रुप ए बी व्हाट इज हैपनिंग? यस. कैन यू सी इन ब्लड ग्रुप ए बी व्हाट इज हैपनिंग? बोथ आर एक्सप्रेसिंग देमसेल्व्स इक्वली. दिस इज ए एग्जांपल ऑफ को डोमिनेंस. Agreed, everyone? Both are dominating. Means both are dominating together. And this is the example of multiple allele. Multiple allele means more than two alleles are there. Now one thing is there. In one individual, only two kind of allele is there. Okay, this is the note. What is the meaning of this note, dear? Tell me. Let's see. In none of the individual there is three allele. Is it there? In none of the individual there is three allele. Only two alleles are there. Only two alleles are there. Tell me. You will ask me, sir, then multiple allele is there for? It is there for population. In the complete population, you will find three types of allele. But in a single individual, you are going to find only two types of allele. Yes or no? Agreed, everyone? Yes. Now, one question. mother is mother having blood group A. And father having blood group B. Then what are the possible blood group for offspring? Tell me. Please think about it. I have told all the possible. In that case, what you should use or not, please think about that and solve this question. Yes. Let's see.
I had a doubt about the question. Is it a heterozygous type of blood group like IAIO or is it just IAIA?
Whenever all the possible type will be asked, whenever it is going to be there, you have to always consider heterozygous condition only. Because in that only maximum number of blood group will be there. If you will take homozygous, only one is possible. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
So whenever all the possible will be asked, you have to take heterozygous only. Agreed, everyone? Are we done? All will be there. See, for blood group A, I will consider IA, IO type. For blood group B, I will consider IB, IO type. Agreed? So let's see, from here, two gametes are possible, IA and IO. And from here also two types of gametes are possible, IB and IO. Let's see over here. Dekho yahan par. I am going to make Punnett square for them. Let's see. IA, IO, and here IB, IO. What will be there in this box? IA, IB, AB type, IB, IO, B type, IA, IO, A type, and IO, IO, O type. All the four are possible. Agreed, dear? Everyone?
Yes, sir. So
we have read this thing. Now, the dihybrid cross. What do you people understand by dihybrid cross? I am going to tell you one simple calculation. By that you can answer anything that is asked. Yes, tell me, dear.
So you didn't explain law of segregation previously.
See, segregation is not based on monohybrid cross. Yes or no? Segregation, no. Sorry. Segregation, I'm going to explain. I have not explained this thing. Law of segregation and law of independent assortment. I am going to explain together so that actually the thing is we are going to confuse few things. Okay. Law of dominance and law of segregation is there on the basis of monohybrid cross, and law of independent assortment is there on the dihybrid cross. I am going to explain. No issues. Just give me 2 minutes. First learn dihybrid cross. Then I am going to tell you. Let's see. Agreed, dear? Tell me. Because we get confused how assortment is taking place and how things are getting segregated. Okay. That is why I will explain both of them together in one diagram. Yes or no? Agreed, dear? Do you people agree? You can say agree with this. I will explain it up. Together only, let's see. Dihybrid cross is cross in which inheritance of two characters are studied. Inheritance of two characters are studied. Yes or no? Let's see. One important thing that I need to tell you. Here is round and yellow seed and wrinkled and green seed. Round and yellow seed. Round is dominant character for shape and yellow is a dominant character for seed color. Yes or no? Wrinkled is a recessive character for seed shape and green is a recessive character for what? For what?
Color.
Tell me. Yes. It is a recessive character for seed color. Now see what all are possible. From this R will come and from this Y will come. In gamete, what I want to tell you people, let's see. See, let me take that diagram first. Okay, then only things will be better. Just a minute. I'm taking this diagram to explain both the thing, segregation as well as independent assortment. Let's see, dear. The thing is, yes, let's see here. Here, the thing is, this is the chromosomal theory of inheritance. Chromosomal theory of inheritance. See, one thing is there, everyone. One thing is there, please try to understand. This is Y, W, this is Y plus W plus. Yes or no? Wild type. wild type is used for dominant one. Yes or no? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Agreed, everyone? Now see, from here, gamete will be formed. Gamete will be formed. Let me take one more diagram. Otherwise, you people will confuse. See. This is the cell. After then, I will explain that thing. See. First thing you should be knowing. Let's see. This is a cell. Okay. For say, this is the cell. Everyone will try to understand this thing. Let's see. From here, see. Here is capital R. This is there. This is RR condition. And here is capital Y. And here is capital Y combination. Yes or no? Everyone, is it there?
Yes, sir.
Is it there? Similar thing is there. Similar thing is there. Let's see what is going to happen over here. Let's see. I should make it with some other color. See, this is a small r, and here is what? Green, for green, a small y should be written. This is there. Only this is there, no? Agreed, everyone? This condition is there. Y is going to represent yellow. Adit, Y is going to represent yellow. Agreed? Let's see. What I want to tell you all, this is one cell. This is another cell. What all kind of gametes are possible over here? Tell me that. What all kind of gametes are possible over here? From this cell, one gamete is going to have capital R, and another gamete is going to have capital Y. Yes or no? This will be formed. Means this is the gamete. One is going to have capital R, and one is means more than one type of chromosomes are there, na? So during meiosis, all the chromosome will divide like that only. This is your gamete, and from this your gamete is like this. Let's see. A small r. A small y. This is your gamete number 2. Yes or no? The cross is going to happen between them only. Agreed? Everyone? Agreed, everyone? No issues? So your, let's see, RY cross RY. You are going to find this. Agreed? Say yes or no?
Yes, sir.
RY cross RY. You are going to find this. Means you are going to have a cell having capital R, having a small r, having capital Y, and having a small y. Now, from this, how many types of gametes are possible? One is with this capital R, capital Y, with this. One is with this capital R, small y. Agreed? One is a small r, capital Y, and one is a small r, a small y. These four types of gametes are possible. Yes or no? And if you are going to put them on both the limbs of Punnett square, you are going to get this result. I think you people have read about this result. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
But do you people know how you can calculate a dihybrid cross from, or trihybrid cross from, you can say, from a monohybrid cross? Do you people know that? This is the traditional method that you people follow. Agreed? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
But you are not going to get that much time so that you can calculate this way. You will make one Punnett square and time will be finished. So you are going to have, actually, the dihybrid cross is a combination of two different cross, that is monohybrid. Aditi is saying multiply. Yes, let's see. I am going to tell you the trick of calculating both the all kind of things very fine, you can say quickly. I will write over here dihybrid cross as a combination of mono hybrid cross. Let's see dear, what is going to happen. See, round is RR, okay? Round is RR, and wrinkled is what? A small r. Everyone? Wrinkled is a small r. Everyone? What is the F1 generation? Or first gametes, let's see about the gametes. What should be the generation 1? It is round.
Yes, sir.
Similar way, yellow is for seed color, capital Y. And green, is it there? Let's see, gamete will be capital Y, here it will be a small y. What is going to be the F1 generation? the generation F1. Agreed, everyone?
Yes,
now,
sir.
I will write about F2 generation. What is the genotypic ratio? It is RR is to RR. It is 1:2, 2:1. Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Everyone? And what is phenotypic ratio? It is round is to wrinkled will be 3:1. Agreed? Everyone? Is it like that?
Yes, sir.
And here, F2 generation. What is the genotypic ratio?
Same, sir.
Sorry, sir. Yes. Capital Y, small y. A small y. It is 1:2, 2:1. And what is phenotypic ratio? It is yellow is to green three is to one. Agreed, everyone? Let's see. Somebody is asking you, question is, what will be the percentage of round yellow seed? Tell me. See, as they have asked you round yellow, round is 3, yellow is 3. Out of 16, it will be 99. It will be 9. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Round yellow. Round 3, yellow 3. Out of 4, it is 3. And out of 4, it is 3. So it will be out of, you can say 9 out of 16. Yes or no? You can just see how many round yellow seeds are there. Calculate from that, you can say diagram or the photo.
9, sir.
It is 9? Into 100 means 9/16 into 100 will be the answer. Agreed, everyone?
Yeah.
Yes. Now, calculate round green seed. Percentage. What will you say? Round is 3 and green is 1. So 3 by 16 into 1. 3/16 into 100. Now, what if will be there if somebody will ask you calculate percentage of seed having genotype RRYY. Can you calculate? What is the percentage of RR? So what is number one? So it will be one. And what is YY?
Two, sir.
Two. So it will be one into two. Means 2/16. Yes or no? Everyone, you can easily observe from here. What, how many are capital R, capital Y, small y? You will find only two. One is here, another is here. Now try to understand my point. Two laws are there. Law of independent assortment. Law of independent assortment. This is based on what? This is based on dihybrid cross. Whose question were there? Earlier you have told me, sir, you have not explained law of segregation. Somebody was saying, no?
Sir, Shraddha here.
Shraddha. Let's see, Shraddha. What is there? Independent assortment means this is moving independent of this round thing. Yes or no? Agreed?
No.
They are making independent combination. This R can come with this Y. This R can come with this Y. Okay, this Y can go with this R, or this Y can go with, you can say, this R. Anything can happen. If they are, means, you can say out of two homologous pair, this is one pair, and this is another pair, means movement of homologous, two different homologous pair of chromosomes are independent of each other, means what I want to tell you over here, that assortment of, getting my point, means one important thing is there, if you see, and one thing is segregation. It is based on monohybrid cross. Let's see what happens. Actually, this law is saying, after, you can say, observing generation one, earlier people had thought that there is some mixing between capital T and small t. That had happened. But what F2 generation has explained, it has not happened. The capital T is getting recovered at the end. Yes or no? Means capital T and small t, they are segregated. They are separate. They are separate. Yes or no? They are moving separately. Agreed, dear? Everyone? And if you have to explain, Shraddha, got it?
Yes, sir.
And what is independent assortment? For that, you require at least two separate homologous pair of chromosome. Means movement of each homologous pair is independent of each other. That is going to fall under law of independent assortment. Yes or no? Everyone? Any doubt?
No, sir.
Everyone?
No doubt, sir.
Means alleles are not getting blended. That is the observation based on F1 and F2 generation. In F1 generation, people have thought that the alleles get mixed up, but the F2 generation has showed us that gametes are not mixing up, rather they are going to recover as it is at the end of F2 generation. Yes or no? So what is law of you can say segregation? This is based on the fact that alleles do not show any blending. Getting my point? As both the characters are recovered as it is in the end. Agreed, dear? Agreed? No issues? This is law of segregation. Clear? Shraddha, are you clear now?
Yes.
And what is law of independent assortment? First, it is based on dihybrid cross. At least two homologous pair of chromosome is required to study this law. Getting my point? No issues?
Yes, sir.
And what do it say? Two pairs of, I'm going to tell you the statement first. Two pairs of what? Two pairs of characters. Agreed? Tell me here. Or traits. Are combined in a hybrid when two pairs of when two pairs of traits are combined in a hybrid, segregation of one pair is independent of the other pair. Agreed? Means how round is getting segregated, it is completely independent of how yellow and green is segregated. Yes or no? Tell me everyone. See, what is happening over here? This YW, getting my point? In F2 generation, you see, how many gametes are possible over here? Capital Y, W, getting my point? Y plus, W plus, they are there, no? Observe this thing. Leave the percentage, that is going to confuse you people. This is some other concept. This is the phenomena of linkage. You need not to, you can say, learn this thing. Yes, I am going to scroll that. You see, from here, Y plus W plus, this is going once with this. although here crossing over is being shown, I think I should make one different diagram for you people by applying law of meiosis. Let's see, give me a minute. You people will confuse in that diagram. I am trying to explain, but you will confuse more. Let's see. This is your cell, na? This is your cell. Agreed? Do you know how chromosomes are going to arrange themselves on equatorial plate?
Yes, sir.
In meiosis one, it will be like this. The two homologous chromosome will be there. Like this. See, what is segregation actually? From that only I will let you know failure of segregation is there. Let's see. Here is capital R, and here is small r and a small r. Here is capital Y is there, and here you can see a small y is there. For say, I am going to explain you people in this only. See, one condition is this and one condition is this. When it will be separating, na, with this a small y can come. Yes or no? Means these two will come towards one cell and these two can come towards another cell. Yes or no? Everyone, this is segregation. Agreed? Say yes or no?
Yes, sir.
But arranging themselves on equator is a random process. Nobody can say what will go and how it will go. Let's see. It can happen another way. Let's see what can be there. These can be a different story also. Let's see. Here a small y, and at this place capital Y is there. Agreed? Now you see, in this condition with capital R, capital Y is going, na? Are yes or no?
Yes, sir.
And in this condition, do you know what is happening with capital R? With capital R, a small y is going. Yes or no? So both the conditions are possible, na?
Yes, sir.
Both the conditions are possible. Is this thing affecting this thing? If they are going to affect, some kind of affinity is there, in that case they should go together always and they should go together always. It is not happening. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
So this is the law of independent assortment. Agreed, everyone? Shraddha, understood dear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, please see to it. I am joining you back in a minute. Yes, everyone. Am I audible now? Am I audible now?
Yes, sir.
Yes. You people have understood that law of independent assortment and law of... Just a minute. Let me take the attendance first. Otherwise, I will forget. And that calculation of dihybrid cross is very important because that is very time-taking job. Okay? So, likewise, you people can calculate trihybrid cross also. Like you can say, as a combination of three monohybrid cross. Yes or no? Everyone? Any cross you people can calculate by that. Now, Five minutes break. Yes, you can have. You can have. No issues. We will start at 7:10. Everyone agreed?
Yes, sir.
Aditya having one doubt. Sir, why shouldn't YY and capital Y and small y move together? In which case, dear? This one? See, I am talking about generation. You can say I am talking about second generation. No? In that case, this had happened. Agreed? Capital R, small r. Capital Y, small r, y is there. No? The main thing is there. I am telling you people, this is one homologous pair of chromosome. Okay? This is another in a cell. How this will move do not depend on this. Yes or no? Agreed? Aditya? So have the alleles been formed? Yes, it will form later on. See, this is meiosis one. I am going to show you the result. Once, take a break. Okay, break will be over by 7:10. Yes, everyone. I'm back. Are you people there?
Yes, sir.
Yes, let's see. See how the chromosome will move, na? I will explain it a bit in meiosis part, okay? Alleles will be formed. Getting my point? If you have a, you can say little bit knowledge of meiosis one and meiosis two, you will understand. I will explain this thing at the time of meiosis. Don't worry. This is done. This is done. Now, exception is done also. Agreed, everyone? Now, the sex determination. One is XX, XY type. Getting my point? One is XX, XY type. One is XX, XO type. And one is ZW, ZZ type. Let's see. In this, if you'll see, you will see XY is the male and XX is female. Agreed? Everyone? Male is XX and female is XY. Agreed? Everyone? Sorry. I have written this thing. Male is XY and female is XX. Agreed? Done? First female is written and then male is written. Yes or no? This is a notion. Yes. Let's see. Male will form how many types of gamete? Tell me, dear.
Two, sir.
Two. One is X. And one is Y. And how many types of gametes are going to be formed by female?
One.
Only one type. Agreed? Type is only one. Everyone. Yes. Let's see. I am making only one. Now if this will combine with female, they will combine agreed done in what all organism it is there it is found in mammals and you can say human is there at least and Drosophila. Agreed everyone? No issues? Now, in female, XY is male. Let's see here. This is known as male heterogamy. Even this is male heterogamy. Agreed, everyone? Let's see what happens. Here, female is XX and male is XO. O means nothing. Female will form only one type of gamete, that is X. And male will form two kind of gamete. One gamete is there with one X chromosome. Another gamete is without any X chromosome. Yes or no? One gamete is there with X chromosome and another gamete is without X chromosome. If they will combine, they will form XX condition, female. And if they will combine, they will form XO condition, that is male. Everyone, tell me, dear. Tell me.
OK. Clear, sir.
Any doubt in this? No issues? And this one, the ZWZZZ type. This is an example of female heterogamy. Here, female is ZW and male is ZZ. ZW, X and Y are a bit of a representation, and it depends on shape of the chromosome also. Female is going to have two kind of gamete, Z and W, and male will have only one kind of gamete, ZZ. So if they will combine, it will form ZZ. If they will combine, they will form ZW. This will be male and this will be female. Agreed, dear? Tell me, ZZ, ZW is found in birds. Birds, okay. Moths are there, I think. Agreed? And in which animal XXXO type of, you can say, sex determination is found? It is there in the insects. Many insects. No issues? Tell me. Okay, an insect also, as I remember, it is grasshopper. What? Agreed, everyone? Do you people agree with this? Tell me.
Yes, sir.
Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Let's see. One is genic balance theory. One is genic balance theory. You people can observe over here. Please observe. What is genic balance theory? Please read it out. Actually, this is given by Sir C.V. Bridge, Calvin Bridge. He stated that, means earlier we used to think that in Drosophila it happens, not in human. He has done this experiment in Drosophila melanogaster only. So he has observed that it is the ratio of X chromosome and autosome which is going to determine the sex, not only the X chromosome, yes or no, or Y chromosome. Agreed? Tell me.
Yes, sir.
No issues? No issues? Now, see this condition. XXX, 2A, they are autosome. The ratio will be 1.5. It will be super female or meta female. Just a minute. I think it has stopped. Just a minute, dear. Just a minute. Just a minute. The screen mirroring has stopped. I'm just restarting that.
So we can see your screen.
Can you see?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
No, you can see the screen actually. Okay, you can see the screen of my laptop, not my iPad.
Yes, sir.
Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Suddenly that has stopped. Just a minute. Just a minute. Just a minute, dear. Am I audible to you? Am I audible now?
Yes, sir.
Yes. See, the thing that is there, it is told by Sir C.B. Bridge. See, here is a screen is visible. No? A screen is visible. No?
Not
yet, actually, at times this happens. Is it visible now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, let's see. What happens? He told it depends on the ratio actually. Getting my point? 1.5 is super female, okay, and 0.5 is male. If ratio is going to be 1, it is female. Actually, this is based on certain studies. There is no clear logic behind it that C.B. Bridge, yeah, you can say, has given. Because in human, it is clear that Y chromosome having certain factors that is going to suppress the formation of female reproductive tract, but it is not there in the Drosophila. If it is 1.5, you can see number of X chromosome is 3, and here it is 2 autosome, so 3 by 2, 1.5. Autosome, you people understand now? Autosome, you people understand now? Tell me.
Yes, sir.
Everyone? So this is there. You people can read of it. Agreed, dear? Anybody else having doubt in this? I think one. Anybody else having any other doubt in this? Let's see. One more thing I would like to discuss over here. There are certain syndromes.
So,
yes.
Can you just show the table again?
Yes. Genic balance theory. After that, you people read your, you can say, textbook very nicely. Okay? Because most of the questions will be there from the basics only. Few of them can go up to higher level. So basic things should be done at any cost.
Done, sir.
Everyone? Now, yes. Certain syndromes are there. Certain syndromes are there. Agreed, dear? One more thing. Do you people have any book for KBPI previous year?
No, sir.
Okay, I will try to send some questions.
Past papers?
Yes, past year papers.
Yeah.
Yes, you can download also. See, one is Down syndrome. See, what happens? It is due to trisomy of chromosome number 21. It is due to autosome. Okay. No issues? Chromosome number 21, trisomy. You understand? What should be there? Ideally, during the segregation, हाँ क्लास में करते हैं बात. हाँ बोलिए. क्लास में. Let's see, dear. Whenever this thing will happen, na, like non-disjunction kind of thing. They will not go to each, you can say, opposite poles. Both will be taken to one pole only. In this case, see, three sets will be there of any chromosome. That is known as trisomy. Usually, how many sets will be there? Only two. Diploid condition. Yes or no? Agreed?
Yes, sir.
So this is due to trisomy. You remember this thing, that's all. Klinefelter syndrome. This disorder is also caused due to presence of an additional copy of X chromosome resulting in a karyotype of 47. Means this person becomes 44 autosome plus XXY. In this case, do you know? It will become 47. Agreed? Now, such overall masculine development. See, whenever this Y chromosome is there, na, only masculine development will take place. Yes or no? Because I have told you Y chromosome having what? Tell me. Y chromosome having certain factors which is going to do what? Certain
masculine development.
Yes. Which is going to suppress the feminine development. So why is there? Masculine development will be there. But as two X chromosomes are there, na, in that case, what will happen? Certain exaggerated, you can say, female character will be there in the male, like gynecomastia. It is the enlarged mammary gland. Yes or no? Enlarged mammary gland. Agreed? Everyone? And the individual will be sterile. One is there, Turner's syndrome. Tell me, dear. In this 44 plus XO will be there. Means Y or X, another Y or X chromosome is missing. total number of chromosome will be 45. Agreed? Everyone? So this individual will be a female. Agreed? This individual will be a female. Why? Y chromosome is not there. Agreed? Tell me. I think now you can ask me, what is your question, Ritu? Yes.
Yes, sir. My question was, is it only the female in the during sexual intercourse, does only the female not have the X chromosome, or does the male also not form a sperm that has X?
See, this is there. X can be there from the male or female, both. Yes or no? Agreed?
Yes, sir.
It is there. If XO condition is there, if XO condition is there, in that case, one of the X chromosome is missing. In that case, even female can be there. Try to understand my point. Then you will understand on your own. If female is XO, try to understand my point. In that case, one gamete will be O also. And male cannot be YO, like C. If male will be YO, means X chromosome is missing, in that case, never ever, getting my point, try to understand my point. If male is YO, in that case, what will happen? This gamete can be, the first condition is female is normal, male do not have Y chromosome. In that case, what will happen? This person will become this is having Turner syndrome. Yes or no?
Yes.
Agreed? Now the second case. Male is absolutely normal. Female is XO. In that case also, you can see if they will combine, it will become XO. It is a chance. You cannot say in which case it is going to be there. Understood? X can be missing from any of the parent. Agreed? Ritu?
Yes, sir. Sorry, my internet.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Understood. Now, one question were there from the, I think, based on modification of leaf. Whose question were there? Shraddha, you have asked the question?
No, sir.
Tell me, whose question were there?
Sir?
Yes?
Sir, I have another question.
See, here somebody asked me over here one question, that which one of the following is modification of leaf? It is onion. Yes, Shraddha, you can ask me a question. Which phone number is there ending with 456? Pranav, you have asked? Yes. Okay. Let's see. Answer will be onion only, dear. Onion is the modified leaf only. Agreed? For the first question, answer will be, which of the following is a modified leaf? It will be onion. Modified fleshy leaf for storage of food. Next question is, see, you have started from the cell membrane. A line drawn from exterior of animal cell to center of nucleus, crossing through one mitote. What is minimum number of membrane bilayers that are that the line will cross? See, one is over here, one is in the mitochondria, and one is the nucleus. So two will be crossed over here. Six. It will be more than six, I think. Let me think. I will send you the answer. I think question is not right. Okay.
Sir, there was one about evolution. They had asked. They had put a rabbit in an island, and yes, they had let it grow. They asked what will be the graph of the population.
They are.
A single rabbit is put in an island and there is good food and there is no disaster. What will be the graph of the population?
See, single rabbit is there, na? Means no predator is there. Initially, it will grow very rapidly. Very rapidly. But after some time, the environmental factor will become limited, and after that it will stabilize. Yes or no?
Yes.
If predator is not there, any animal is going to grow or plant is going to grow very rapidly, but all the environmental factors are going to be there in place. Once its resources will be limited, you can say will be exhausted, and then the population is going to crash. Either it will stabilize or it will go like this. It can decline also. Agreed? Like if plants are no vegetation is not growing, in that case it will decline also. Agreed?
Yes.
But it is more likely in my opinion. If question is there with you, you can send it to me. Yes.
Yes, sir, I can send it.
Shraddha, what is your question? Tell me, dear.
So could you just explain that part where you said 44 plus XXY gives you 47 chromosomes and that calculation part again?
44 is the autosome. 44 is the autosome, 2X chromosome, 46 and 1Y chromosome, 47.
So you're taking each of them as one chromosome and not them to one single thing.
Yes, that is one chromosome only. We have 22 pairs plus XX or 22 pair plus XY. If I have written 44 over here, that means I have counted one chromosome. Okay, one homologous has one homologous pair has two chromosomes. Yes or no?
So if Y does not have the other part of it, it will still be counted.
Yes, it will be counted, na? In number of chromosome, it will either you say pair, or if pair is not there, in that case, total number of chromosome will be counted. Yes or no?
Yes.
Y is always single. What you do? 22 pairs autosome plus 1X, 1X and 1Y. So it will become 44 plus 45 plus 1 plus 1. Means 44 plus 145 plus 146. Agreed, dear?
Yes, sir. Got it.
Read your, you can say, and say textbook very nicely. If you have any doubt, you can send it to me. Now exam time is there. You can ask me for doubts. You can connect to me some other time also, apart from the class. Sir, Adit, what is, isn't it three? You are saying three? For that question, let me think again. For that question, Adit. Oh, membrane question. Let me think. If you are here to discuss, I'm going to discuss that. Let's see. see, this is one membrane bilayer. Mitochondria is bilayered, na? One. And then nucleus is also bilayer. So one is this, two, three, four, five. Five is answer. Let's see. Five is there in the option. It is not there. That is why I'm saying, let me think. Is there any modification in the inner mitochondrial membrane? Agreed here? Why it is there? How you are saying three? Because mitochondria and nucleus is bilayered, na?
Sir, isn't the cell membrane is also having four layers?
Cell membrane having?
Sir, cell membrane having two layers, right?
See, that is why I am counting this as, I am counting this as one bilayer. I am counting this as one bilayer. Agreed? This is one bilayer. This is another bilayer. This is another bilayer. This is all our unit membrane only. This is another bilayer. So it should be five. There should be five in option. Let me check it once. Okay. If at this time I am missing something, I am going to let you know.
Sir, actually, it was a bonus question. The answer was five.
Okay.
Like in the actual
paper. That is why I'm telling you people. Understood? Understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Bye, everyone.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. If you people have any doubt and any question, you can send that question to me anytime. Your exam is going to be there, and any topic is there that you need to understand, you can contact me personally also. I will see to it. Okay?
Thank you, sir.
Okay, dear.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.